In 2019 alone, there was a production of more than 513 million metric tons of milk throughout the world, which is more than 10% of what was produced in 2013. And it is estimated that an average person drinks 90 kg of milk every year, and the demand will still increase because the population of the world is increasing day by day. So in this video today, we are going to cover the story of this milk right from the start, where it is produced, how it is produced, how it is processed, and to the end when it goes to your body. So how does the journey of milk start? The milk starts off as a calf, and a calf is a young cow. So this journey starts when cow gives birth to a young calf, which is either male or female. And now you might wonder what happens to the male, because male is not going to give a milk in the future. So what farmers do is they usually raise male calf for a meat, whereas they raise female calf for a milk. So when the female calf is born, they are kept in a calf pen where they are fed colostrum. This colostrum is a very thick milk which is rich in vitamins, other nutrients and immune cells, which gives immunity to young calf. In human also, when the new baby is born, doctors and nurses, they encourage you to give colostrum for the first few days, because that gives immunity to the young baby and other nutrients as well. So after they are fed colostrum, they are then fed highly nutritious milk and also a little bit of grain. And feeding of grain is important at that time, because when they are separated from their mother, then they can be reared in a full grain diet, and also the diet without milk. Once they are a little bit older, they will be transferred to a young cow pen, which is a little bit bigger, where you can keep many young cows, where they can run, they can do whatever they want, and they will grow together with their pen mates. And those young cows are kept like that for almost 2 years, and after 2 years they are ready to become a mother and give milk. So where do cows live? There are basically two types of housing. One of them is called tie stall, and another one is called loose housing. In a tie stall, cows are tied in a stall-like structure, and the feed and water is provided in front of the cow. I'm personally not a big fan of tie stall, because cows are tied mostly throughout the day, and that might give rise to feed problem as well, and they may not be able to express their normal behavior like walking, running, because they are tied mostly. But the good thing about this tie stall is manure is collected behind the cow in the gutter, so it is easy to manage them. Whereas in loose housing, the cows are kept loose, they are not tied, they have a lying area, they have separate feeding and drinking area. The one problem is the manure, cow dung will be all over the place, and you will have to collect them by hand or a scraper. So in the tie stall, milking is done either in a bucket or by a milking machine in the same area, whereas in loose housing, milking is done separately in a milking parlor. So what do they eat? You might be interested to know that cow has four stomach. If you fill your stomach, you can see only one pouch, but in cows, there are four of them. And one of them is called rumen, which is really, really rich in bacteria. And bacteria is really important, because cow eat grass, which is really complex, and those bacteria will help digest those grass. So cow has those four stomach. And the interesting thing about cows is when cow eat grass, they first swallow, and they again take out that swallowed grass to the mouth, chew it, again swallow, and again take out to the mouth. That process is called regurgitation, which is really important to break down the complex grass so that it can be easily digested. So 50% of cow's diet is around grass, and 25% is something like grain, and rest is cottonseed meal, canola meal, or alfalfa, or something like that. So grass, grain, and little bit of meal. And to provide a context, a cow can eat 1500 slices of bread every day and almost 130 liters of water every day. Isn't that interesting? So now let's talk about a milk. A newborn calf is ready to become a mother when it is 2 years old, and after 2 years old it is inseminated, and after it becomes pregnant for around 40 weeks, then it will give birth to another newborn calf, and then it starts giving milk. So on an average, a good cow gives 40 to 50 liters of milk, which is something like 100 of these kind of glasses with milk. And when a cow gives birth to a young calf, the milk gets collected in a udder, which is a breast-like structure, and this udder has four teats. If you compare that to human has two breasts and two nipples, whereas cow has one udder and four teats. So in a big farm, what happens is that milk is collected in a milking parlor. So all those cows, they go into the milking parlor where udders are cleaned, and then milking machine is tied into the teat and milk is collected. Once milk is collected, the technician quickly tests the quality of the milk, and that is sent to the dairy for processing. After milking, the milk has to go through several processes until it is ready to be sold. So what happens is, immediately after collection in the milking machine, milk goes through a pipe which cools milk down to 3 degrees Celsius. Cooling down of milk is really important, because if the milk is hot, then large number of bacteria will grow in the milk, which makes milk very sour, and that ruins the quality of the milk. So it is really important milk is cooled down to the temperature of 3 degrees Celsius. Once milk is cooled down to the temperature of 3 degrees Celsius, then it is shipped to the dairy in a truck which can maintain the temperature of 3 degrees Celsius, and then when it reaches the dairy, it is kept in a holding tank. And after the holding tank, milk goes through a machine called separator, which separates milk from cream. Cream is a fat, and the milk without a cream is called skim milk. And later on, what they do is they will add different amount of cream to the milk, skim milk, to make something like 2% fat milk, 4% fat milk, 10% fat milk, or depending on the need. And before that milk is ready to be sold, it has to again go through the process called pasteurization. You might have heard of a scientist named Louis Pasteur, who discovered the pasteurization process. So in this process, what happens is milk will go through 72 degrees centigrade for 15 minutes, and that milk will immediately chill down to the temperature of 3 degrees Celsius. This helps prevent the growth of bacteria, which is really important from food safety point of view. If the milk is not pasteurized, then that might lead to foodborne diseases and other complications. So the pasteurization process is really important from food safety point of view. And once the pasteurization is complete, then milk is ready to be packed in a different kind of bottles. Some of them could be glass bottle, some of them could be plastic bottle. If you talk about Australia, they are packed usually in the bottle like that. This is a 2-liter bottle, and some other could be packed in a 4-liter bottle, and also 1-liter bottle as well. And once they are packed in a bottle like this, what dairy does is they will put a label, something like this, which has a name of a milk, which has a ingredient list, which also has a nutrient composition, and also barcode, and the address where the milk was made. And also they will need to provide a use by date or best before date. And in this example, the best before date, use by date is 31 May 2021. That means milk is fresh until 31 May 2021. And once the milk is packed in the bottle, then they are kept in a crate in a cooler of around 3 degrees Celsius until they are shipped to the store. So now milk are shipped to the store in a truck, which can maintain the temperature of roughly around 3 degrees Celsius again. And once there is the store man immediately keep them in a chiller below the temperature of 4 degrees Celsius, and they will display those milk in a display refrigerator, which can again maintain the temperature of below 4 degrees centigrade. So if you go to the store, you might see different type of milk. Some of them are packed in 2-liter, 4-liter, 1-liter, and some of them are like chocolate milk or different flavored milk as well. So now you have bought a milk from the store in a pack like this. Always remember to keep your milk in the refrigerator as soon as you reach home, because that helps maintain quality of the milk. So now you can drink milk however you like, either cold or hot. I personally like drinking warm milk every day, because it helps keep me healthy. Also, if you are growing, it is really important that you drink milk every day, because milk is a resource of calcium that helps make your bone strong, and that keeps you healthy. So guys, this is the story of the milk. I hope you like the story of the milk. If you like this story, please leave your comments down below in the comment section. And also if you like my channel, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll see you again in next video. Until then, bye. Thank you for watching.